the state of California, and it was a practice for SBAC. This is one of the things that was on it, so I'm going to go through it with you. I'm going to start. We'll probably pull out another one of those FIABs because, again, the one thing that happened last year was we could have had calculus could have moved the percentage the school did, how many people got advanced or proficient. We had a bunch of kids who could have like moved it up. So, and that's a significant thing to move a school a percentage point or two. So I want to make sure you're going into the SBAC and you know what you're doing. And it's a pain because it happens at the same time as AP testing. So we're going to do it little by little. I will probably pick on the stuff that is furthest removed from us, the closer we get to SBAC. So the algebra stuff, let's tackle all of that now and make sure we've got all that down because you need it for calculus anyways. So, all right, this should look very, very familiar. I kind of put three different versions of this problem there today. What do I have to, I'm solving for X. So what do you think I should do first? Add 75, good. So we get 3X equals 75. Oops, sorry, thank you, x squared. Okay, how do I undo the 3? Divide, so x squared equals what? 25, good. All right, how do I undo the square? Square root, technically what's supposed to go out front? Plus or minus, so x equals plus or minus what? 5. In calculus, in our calculus world that we live in the next year or two, we don't see an I. But you have to, the SBAC might have an I. I didn't put any I ones in there today, okay? So what do we have to be careful of? If there's a negative under the radical, what do I have to do? You gotta pluck your I's out, okay? So just kind of keep that in mind. Anytime you solve a quadratic that's non-calculus quadratic, you might have to pluck an I out. Okay, let's look at the next one. I amped it up a little bit. So what do I have to do with this 24? Add, so 2x squared equals 24. What do I do with the 2? Divide, so what's 24 divided by 2? Good. All right, how do I undo the squared? What has to go in front? Plus, ooh, plus, plus, that's weird. Plus, minus. Okay, now, calculus world, we're done. We don't simplify radicals, okay? But in the algebra world and the SBAC world, we're going to have to simplify a radical. So, what's the biggest square number that goes into 12? 4, 3. And I picked on one that was really, really small. I'll make sure that when we do this little quiz, you've got a calculator in there and you have the square numbers are up over here. I think they must have fallen down on the other side of the room, but they're up over here if you need them. Okay. All right. What's the square root of 4? 2 square root of 3. Okay, and this is the solving by roots method. We know we can solve by factoring. We know we can solve by completing the square. We know we can solve by quadratic formula. This is the one where you basically have a singular x and it's easier to just take the square root of both sides kind of thing, okay? All right, on this one here, what are we gonna do first? Add 18, so we've got x minus 2 squared equals 18. How do we undo the square? We're going to square root. What has to go in front? Plus or minus. So I've got x minus 2 equals plus or minus. I'm going to try to simplify that in this step. What's the biggest square number that goes into 18? 9. Remember, we have to look over on their squares list and you go down the list. So you go 4. 4 doesn't divide it. I try 9. 9 works. If 9 doesn't work, then I have to keep going. Until I exceed the number, right? You want, and by divide, I mean it has to go in there and be nice looking like another integer, okay? All right, how many times? 2, good. All right, we're gonna do two things at once. What's the square root of 9? 3 square root of 2. Notice I left a gap there, right? How do I move this 2 to the other side? Add. So it'd be 2 plus or minus 3 square root of 2. You would not put these together, okay? This is like having a 3x. It's not a like term with that 2. Okay? All right. That's it on that. All right. Let's switch over to the notes we were working on Friday.